In this video, we will learn how to communicate with a database from LabVIEW. So the software we need in this video is Microsoft SQL Server and the LabVIEW programming environment. Microsoft SQL Server can be downloaded for free if you use the Microsoft SQL Server Express Edition. LabVIEW software can be downloaded from this link. So here is what we are going to do in this video. We are going to use Microsoft SQL Server. Here we are going to manage the database. So we are going to create a table. And then we are going to create some LabVIEW programs that communicate with the database, both reading and writing data from and to the database. So what is a database system? In all good days, they used a database like this. But today, most of the data are stored in so-called database systems. So a database is a structured way to store lots of information, and the information is stored in different tables inside the database. And basically everything today is stored in databases. Here we have some examples, typically bank account systems, information in web pages such as Facebook, Wikipedia, YouTube, etc. are all stored in a database system. Here are some examples of typical database management systems. We have Oracle, MySQL, MariaDB, Sybase, Microsoft Access, and we have Microsoft SQL Server, which we are going to use in this video. So, a little bit introduction to SQL Server. Microsoft SQL Server is created by Microsoft, and you can divide it into two parts. You have one database engine, which is just a service running in the background on your computer, handling all the data, storing the data, and handling input and output from different users and systems. And then we have the Management Studio, which is a graphical user interface that the user can use to manage the database. Here you can create tables, etc. In this video and in these examples, we are going to use a very simple database. So you are just going to create a simple database just containing one simple table. So we'll create a school table with those columns inside the tables. So let's do this example inside SQL Server. So now I have opened Microsoft SQL Server and the Management Studio. So let's start creating the database. Just click on Databases, New Database, and then create a name for the database. In this case, we can call the database for school, like this, and just click OK. And then inside the database, you can click on Tables, and then we can right-click and create a table. In this case, we are going to create a school table. So we have this primary key called school ID, which could be an integer. This, and then we have the name, the school name. Name could be varchar, so let's set just varchar 50, and then we have a description like this. We can also set varchar for this one. We could set varchar 100 or something, and then since the school ID is the primary key, we just right click here and set primary key like this. And also, when we are inserting data into this table, we want the primary key to be an identity column. So we click on the school ID column, go into properties here, and we set identity specification is identity, and then we set it to yes, and then The school ID will be automatically be incremented every time we enter a new school inside the table. Next, you just need to save the table. So you click on the save symbol and just enter the name of the table, which is school in this case, like this, and then click OK. And now if you go to tables here, you see that the school table has been created inside the database. Next, we want to enter some data into the table, so we will use SQL for that. SQL is a structured query language and is a language used in database systems. So here we see some example. Here, this is a typical query where we select data from the school table. In this case, select school ID name from school. Here are some other examples. We have four different types. So we have insert you can use when you want to insert data into the database or the tables. We use select when you want to get data from the table. And if you want to change some data, we use the update. If you want to delete data, we use the delete statement. So let's create some SQL examples from scratch. Now we are back inside SQL Server, and then we want to create some or insert some data into the school table. So just let's select new query. And then here we can enter a query in order to insert data into the school table. So let's insert some data. Insert into the school table, like this. Then we need the column names, so we have the name, description. You don't need to put the school ID here because it's automatically generated. And then have some values. Then name. We could have the school. NTNU. And description. Norwegian University or something like this, and then you can click on execute in order to execute the query. Yeah, so you see here the name need to be like this. Let's try once more. Yeah, now see the database has been updated with data. So now next we can create a new query to see if we can see the data inside the table. So then we use the select statement. Select all from the school table like this. And then you can just execute it and then see this school has been put into the database. Next, if you want to communicate with the database from other sources, we typically need to create an ODBC connection. Creating an ODBC is something you do inside Windows. So you open the ODBC window in the tools in Windows. And then you can click add in order to create a new ODBC connection to the specific database. In order to do that, we just need to go through some steps in order to configure the ODBC. And finally, if everything is configured correctly, it will work as expected. So let's create this example from scratch. So now we have opened the ODBC configuration panel inside Windows. And then you click add in order to create a new ODBC. Here we need to select the proper driver. So since we are using Microsoft SQL Server, we need to select the driver for Microsoft SQL Server. Click finish. We need to select a name for our ODBC connection. So we call it just for test my ODBC. And then we need to select the server. So we select our server, which is this in our case. We click next. Here we type the authentication we need to use. You can choose either one of these. I just leave this one and click next. Here we need to set the database we want to connect to. So we need to find our school database like this. Click next. Here we can set some information, but we just leave this information by default and click finish. And here we can test the connection and see if it works properly. And then it seems to work properly like this, and then just click OK. And then our ODBC appears in the list here. Next, I will go into LabVIEW and see how we can communicate with the database from LabVIEW. So first, I will introduce LabVIEW SQL Toolkit, which is an easy toolkit that we can use to communicate with the database. So the toolkit is created by me. It consists of four main functions. We have one SQL open function, and we have a function for selecting data or getting data from the database, and then we have a function for inserting or updating data into the database. Then we need a close function in order to close the connection to the database when we are finished. You can download this toolkit for free from this source. When you have downloaded and installed the SQL toolkit, then you will get this palette inside LabVIEW with these four functions. Next, I will go through some simple examples inside LabVIEW, how we can use LabVIEW and the SQL toolkit to insert and select data from the database. So the first example here is how we can use the toolkit to get data from the database. Next example is how to write data into the database from LabVIEW. So let's start with the example number one, where we get data from the database into LabVIEW. And then we use these three functions. We need to use open to open the connection to the database. And then we need to use the select function in order to write a query. And then we have a two-dimensional data here, where the data from the database is stored inside LabVIEW. When you are finished, we can close the connection to the database. So let's create this example from scratch within LabVIEW. So let's create this simple example inside LabVIEW. Now I open LabVIEW and a blank block diagram. So I just right-click to find the SQL toolkit palette. Click it here. I find it here in the bottom, like this. So here are the four functions. Like this. So in this example, we always need the SQL open in order to open the connection to the database. And we need in this example the SQL select function. And then we need to close the connection to the database like this. Those three functions is all we need in this example. So let's start with open here. If you click Control H, you can get a help window where you see the inputs and outputs on each function. In this case, we need to connect our ODBC connection. So we just right click here on the connection, select create and constant. Here we can type just the name of our ODBC. So in our case, it was my ODBC. That's the name of our ODBC connection. And then the output here will be a connection out, which we need to wire into the SQL select like this. And the output here needs to be wired to the close like this. If you go to the select function, you see it has an query input which we need to use. So we just right click, create, and create a constant. And then we can write a query inside here. In this case, we want to get all the data in this from the school table. So let's create a query. Select all from school, like this. And then the data from the school table should be shown on our front panel. So you just click on the output here, the data output, just right click, create, and an indicator. So if you double click on the indicator here, it's just a two-dimensional array that you can see on our front panel. So let's make it a little bit bigger like this. And we go back to the block diagram. Like this. Now we are almost finished. It's also a good practice to wire the error out to the error in. Like this, and the same here. Then when, if you get some error, you can use this simple error function like this. And if it gets, if there are some errors inside our code, it will be displayed in this error handler like this. So just let's save our program. File, save. We can just save it on the hard drive. The name, with a proper name. Getting data into lab view example or something. Click OK. And then now our program should be ready to run. So let's go to our front panel and then click on the run button. And then you see we got the data from the database inside LabVIEW. So let's create the next example where we insert data from LabVIEW into the database. So in this case, we need to use the same open, but instead of the select, we use the SQL execute VI. And then we close it like this. So let's create this example from scratch using LabVIEW. So I have created a new blank VI within LabVIEW. And here we have our SQL palette. And let's start creating the program. So let's use the SQL open. We need to use the SQL execute. And then SQL close like this. Then let's start with SQL open. Then here we needed to enter the ODBC connection. So my ODBC like this. And the output here, the connection goes to this one and to this one. And the error goes from this to this, and from this one to this one. And then we use the same simple error handler like this. And then next we go to the SQL execute function, and then we have to write the query for inserting data. So just right click, create constant, and let's start writing the query. So you want to insert into the school table, you want to insert name and description like this. Then the values. Values. You can enter a new name, USN, and the description. USN is the University College of Southeast Norway. like this. So now we have entered the query, and now we should be able to run the program and insert some data inside the database. So let's just click the run button. Yeah, and nothing happened inside LabVIEW. It didn't get any error. So let's go back to SQL Server and see if the data was saved. Now we are back in the management studio within SQL Server, and here we have our query. So let's run this query, execute, and you see the new school we just entered inside LabVIEW is now stored inside the database. Instead of using an ODBC connection, we could have used this approach instead. So here, instead of using an ODBC and set up an ODBC connection, we can enter the connection string to the database directly like this. So we have the provider, which is SQL database, and data source is the name of my computer and the name of the database. And then we need to enter the user and the password for our database. And finally, the name of the database like this. Now we are going to create a more advanced database example in LabVIEW. In this example, we are going to log measurement data into the SQL Server. So we are going to log data from a temperature sensor. In this case, we will use a TC01 thermocouple device from National Instruments. But you could use other kind of measurement devices. So here is our graphical user interface. We just read the values from the sensor. And here we have our program. You can see it a little bit larger here. So we use the open to open the connection to the database. And then here we have a while loop. And inside the while loop, we read values from the sensor. And then we use an insert statement to insert data in some interval here. So we can select, let's say, every 10 seconds or every seconds here. And then every 10 seconds in this case, the temperature value will be stored into the database. And we have used the format into string to format the insert statement. So we get the values from the sensors inside the database like this. So let's create this example from scratch. We start with SQL Server and create the new table. So for simplicity, I will just create the new table, the tag data table, within the same database as we created earlier. So this table contains of three columns, the tag ID, which is just the primary key, the value or the temperature value from the sensor, on the timestamp, like this. So let's go to LabVIEW and create the program. So now I created a blank VI in LabVIEW, and let's start creating the simple user interface. So we just use a simple thermometer like this. And then we need just a simple stop button. And then we can go to our program, the block diagram, like this. So we need a while loop, and we use the stop button to stop the while loop like this. And then we need to read the values from the thermocouple device. So then we use a measurement IO palette, docmx, and the doc assistant function like this. So when you place this on the block diagram, we need to go through a wizard. So in this case, we're going to acquire signals, which is an analog input. In this case, a temperature signal and a thermocouple. Then you see we find, and the wizard find our device, and then we just select analog input 0 and click finish like this. And here we have some settings. And use the built-in, and this is a thermocouple of type J, and you can select one sample on demand. And here you can set some range, 0 to 100 degrees Celsius, like this. So you just click on the OK button, and this function will be automatically generated for us. Like this. And next, you want to use this timer. You can use this one. And in this case, we just set 1000. So we log data every 1000 milliseconds or every second. And then we need our database communication VIs. So we start using, we find the SQL palette, and we need to use the open, we need to use the execute, and we need to use the close function like this. And let's just wire the functions together. So now we are almost finished with our coding. So we have our the SQL open, execute, close, and a simple error handler. We read data from the DAC device like this. We have used the convert from dynamic data in order to convert from this data type to this more ordinary double data type. And we have used this wait function, and we have this stop button. Next, we have created our query here, which insert data into the database. And next, we want to use the format into string like this. And then we wire the query into this function like this. And then the output is wired into the execute function like this. And now the function should, the code should work as expected. So let's try the code. We go to the front panel. So we have this simple user interface. We have the thermometer, which is showing the latest value, and we have a stop button. We could also add a chart to see the values inside the chart. So let's go to this graph palette and select waveform chart like this, and connect the chart like this, and then we should be able to see the values also inside a graph. And now our graphical user interface should be finished. So let's start the program. And see, we're starting to get values from the sensor. The real time value is shown in the thermometer, and the historical data is shown in a waveform chart. So if I squeeze my temperature measurement device, you see the temperature will get higher like this. And if you now go to SQL Server to see if the data is stored. Here we have our table, and then let's make a simple query to get data from this table. So select all from tag data, and we just click execute, and then we see data has been logged into the table. So for each second, we get a new point into the database like this. So that's a very simple application, that logging data from a real temperature device into the database like this. So that's all for today. Thank you.